Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to walk everyone through how to use the Montena PG1275E, which you'll see in front of me right here. And this test system is used for mil standard 1275 voltage spikes and surges. So during today's video, we're going to walk through setting up the equipment, both through the front and the back panel. Then we're going to move on to adjusting some different testing criteria, both through the front panel display, which you'll see right here, as well as through the Montena software. Following that, we're going to run a couple pulses, probably one of the voltage spikes and a surge, and then we're going to go ahead and capture those with our oscilloscope. All right, so now let's go ahead and let's get started with the front panel. Okay, here you're going to find the front side of the PG1275E. So taking a look on the upper left corner here, you'll see the front panel display. You will see right there, you can choose the different transients, spikes or surges. And just to the right of that, you'll see the turnstile. So that's going to allow you to select different criteria on the screen. And when you do want to go into that associated menu, you just compress the turnstile and it will take you there. So when you do want to go back, you just go to the menu local button, which is the right one indicated right down here, and compress it. That's going to kind of take you back to the home screen. Now taking a look just below the display right here, you'll see the pulse button, and that's just going to release the charge pulse with the criteria that you have selected. Just to the right of that, you'll see high voltage. That's just going to be the indicator that your pulse is charging. And we already spoke about the menu local, and just to the right of that, you'll see the interlock button. And what that's going to indicate is that the interlock is not present on the back of the system, or that your emergency stop button has been compressed. And that's one thing we do want to talk about briefly, is the emergency stop button. So commonly with shipping, these get bumped around a little bit, and this emergency stop button can be compressed just like that, and you'll see that right there. And that means the interlock is indicated as being lit up. However, we do have the interlock in the back of the system. So if you do get the system and you do see that interlock indicated, that light on, and you do have the interlock in the back, just take a look at the emergency stop button and be sure it's not compressed. And all you have to do is just turn it and you'll see that light go off. All right, so that should just about wrap up the front side of the PG1275E. Let's go ahead and turn around and walk through the different connections along the back side of the system, as well as a couple different things you want to be aware of. Here is the back side of the PG1275E. So let's go ahead and start in the upper right hand corner. That's where you see the option to select the different voltages. You'll see 115 and 230. So for today's video, we're going to have the 115 selected. Just to the left of that, you will see the USB connection. For today's video, that's going to be going to our computer with the control software. Just below that, you will see the RS232 and the interlock. So as we mentioned previously, then that interlock, if that's not placed in that connector, you will see that front panel light displayed. Just to the left of that, you will see these different selections and outputs for surges and spikes right there. And you will see we do have the gray jumper put in place. This connection, if you were to remove that jumper, would be used for the 400 amp diode you can use for some higher current power leads. For today's video, we're not going to use that, so we're going to keep that inserted. Okay, so that should just about wrap the backside. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the front panel display and walk through modifying some different testing criteria. Okay, so now let's go ahead and modify some different testing parameters from the front panel display. Let's go ahead and take a look at spikes. And you will see a couple different criteria there. We have voltage, period, and pulses. On the voltage, you'll see two different values, the left value being 400 volts, and that's the value you're setting the voltage at, and the right is going to be the actual voltage. And you'll see that change when you hit the high voltage button. Just below that, you'll see a period, and that's going to be set at 1 second right now, and that's just going to be the time between pulses. And then following that, you'll see pulses indicated right there, and that's going to be the amount of pulses, the set versus the counter. And the counter is going to be on the left side, and then the number of pulses set is going to be on the right side. Following that, you will see a kind of bold spikes menu indicated right there. That's going to be set at standby. You will see that change when you do hit that high voltage charge button that we talked about previously. So let's go ahead and go back to the main menu real quick. Let's go ahead and take a look at surges. right there, and you will see it is a very similar menu to the spikes menu. You can go ahead and modify those same parameters underneath this menu. Okay, so I think that should just about wrap it up with modifying different testing criteria from the front panel display. Let's go ahead and connect our laptop with the USB port on the back side of the generator and take a look at the testing software. Okay, so now let's go ahead and walk briefly through the mill standard 1275E automation software. So for today's video, we don't have our generator or our oscilloscope hooked up, so you will receive a few errors here and there on the screen. So let's go ahead and look just below set communication to the mode. So this allows you to select either spikes or surges. We're going to go ahead and for today's video, we're just going to leave it on spikes. Just above that, you will see set communication. Regardless of which mode you're using the software in, you want to be sure you are setting the communication. So taking a look here, you see a couple different drop downs. Starting with the generator port, you will see COM 3. So when you hit the drop down here, if you can enter the COM port that the generator is set to, otherwise you can hit refresh and that should eventually populate that. And then when you hit check generator, you will see the ID entered in this box here. Following that, you will see the oscilloscope type. So there's several different series of oscilloscopes that the transient generator will work with. There is a PDF document which walks through a little bit more detail of the different variations of these types, which are supported. So you can go ahead and reference that. However, you can see there if we do select a Tektronix MDO, MSO, or DPO right there, and you hit refresh and your oscilloscope is hooked up to your computer, you should see all that information populate there. So there's one more area you do want to be aware of here, and that's going to be your channel. So you'll see channel number right there, voltage, channel number current. So if you do have your differential probe hooked up to channel one, you want to be sure that's indicated, and then your current monitoring probe hooked up to the associated channel there. You just want to be sure that is selected. All right, so now let's go ahead and look at calibration. And this is just a little brief kind of overview of the calibration. It gives you a picture of the setup. You can see right there, mill standard 1275E voltage probe. You can select this if it's, you know, 1 to 100, 1 to 10. That's options for you right there. So once all this information is added, all you have to do is hit the start F12 button right there, and it will actually run the calibration communicating with the transient generator using your oscilloscope data to drive a waveform on the screen here. We don't actually have it hooked up right now, so let's just go ahead and exit this panel. Let's take a look at the test option right here real quick as well. So taking a look, this is the injected spikes test. You'll see that indicated in the top left corner, which will be right up here. Just below that, you will see a setup kind of configuration with the current monitoring probe, as well as differential voltage probe right there. It has got a power supply and a listen, as well as the ET. So taking a look here, you will see a couple different options you can select. You'll see injection type, probes, as well as the voltage again. So if you have it at a 1 to 100, just indicate that as well. So taking a look down here, this will be the calibration file name. You can see right there, number of pulses, pulsing periods, and then power supply. So when you do go ahead and get everything set up, you are ready to run that test. You go ahead and hit this start F12 right there, and that's going to run the test. All right, so that should be just about it for the mill standard 1275E automation software. Again, this software is really easy to use, so it really shouldn't be an issue once you have communication set up with your oscilloscope. All right, so now let's go ahead and run a few pulses from our transient generator. We'll go ahead and we'll do one spike and one surge, just to be sure we are getting out the associated pulse criteria that we are putting in. All right, so now let's go ahead and let's verify the wave shapes for both spikes and surges using the PG1275E. So let's go ahead and start with spikes. And this waveform is verified directly from the backside of the generator using our differential probe. So we're gonna set it at 2000 volts for today, a period of 1 second, and we're only interested in one pulse. So let's go ahead and select the high voltage. And we are ready. And then hit the pulse when you are ready to send the pulse. All right, so taking a look at the waveform there, it does look to be the correct shape. Again, this is just a very quick verification. Now let's go back to our main menu. All right, so now let's take a look at the surge. All right, so we do have the voltage set at 200 volts, a period of 5 seconds, and like I mentioned earlier, we're really only interested in one quick verification, so we only need one pulse today. So when you are verifying for the surge test, you want to be sure you do have your 0.5 ohm resistor coming out from the backside of the transient generator, and then to your differential probe, and then finally to your oscilloscope. So let's go ahead and hit high voltage. Let it charge real quick. All right, looks like we're ready to go, and then go ahead and hit pulse. All right, so let's take a brief look at the waveform. All right, that looks good. So that should just about wrap it up for today. We hope this video has been useful, walking through a little bit about the transient generator, some of the different capabilities, how to modify some different testing parameters. Please keep us in mind if you're ever out there and need to rent any EMC or EMI test equipment, including this PG1275E or any of the associated accessories. Thank you. Bye.